to say that I feel like everything they did leading up to this point was exactly the way it was meant to be. They got together when they were young, they separated for a while, explored things on their own, and realized, you know what? No, I like you. You're my person. And they got back together and they knew this was it. It's real. We're doing it. And here we are today. They are married. They are Mr. and Mrs. Rodriguez. And honestly, me and Johnnie had this thing where I called him my fake son-in-law and he called me fake mother-in-law. We said F-Sil and F-Mil. It was our own little thing. Even on my phone, it's still that way. So now today, I can officially remove the F, and now he is my son, and I'm his mom. This day is honestly, one of the best days of my life. I'm so happy for you guys. Welcome to the family, Johnnie. I think I can speak on behalf of all of the vid party when I say that we are so excited that you are official now. And you are officially part of the vid party of 18. So cheers! Yeah, buddy!
The roasting does not stop. And that's what we're talking about in the Rodriguez family. It's like, that's how we show love, you know? It's like, if you can't take it from family member, then the world is gonna be a tough place for you guys as a couple.
And so Liana has always been my little baby, Liana Banana. Until this day, she acts so much older than I do. You know, like, I'm just like, I ask her for advice. She encourages me a lot. And Johnnie, God, I love Johnnie. Like, he just has such a great attitude all the time. And I love watching them fight. It's so funny, like, because it's just cute. Like, they bicker, but it's just like the kind of bickering that I would want, because they just kind of like, they get over it, you know what I mean? They work through it, and that's what you're supposed to do, because a lifetime is a long time, and like, fun bickering and
But what I really love about Liana is she is everyone's kid. I see parts of me in her. I see parts of Lynette, obviously her mom, my dad, Lisa, Jason, Derek, Barry. She is truly blessed, as we are blessed with her, to have such a strong family. And now we get to be even more blessed to add Johnnie to that mix.
He's someone I've always looked up to. He's a lot of the things that I got into as a kid, I got into because of him. I could think of like Legos, Yu-Gi-Oh, LARPing, live action role playing. You know, don't play. Liana, you know, I've had you at my house for Thanksgiving. Well before we even developed a great relationship, but I'm so happy to call you a part of my family and to have extended our family, you know, because it is our family.
I've seen John go through every stage of his life. And, you know, he went from, I seen him grow up as a child, teenager, and now adult. I had no doubt in my mind that he was the most responsible out of anybody in our group at the time. And I knew for a fact that he'd be the first one to get married versus all of us.
Thank you. so happy for you guys. ¿Quieren español? Oh, ¿quieren español? No, I'm happy for you guys. Can you translate for me, please? Solamente que estoy feliz por ustedes y los quiero mucho. And desde el principio yo sabía que ella era la perfecta mujer para ti.
Yeah.
Solo que cuando quebraron, corté la fotografía de Liana con Tatán porque estaba enojada. I was so angry. Yeah. I was like, why? Why you love my son?
Yeah, but
I love you guys. Congrats.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and for you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people passing by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying,
I'm honored to call these two lovebirds my best friends. I've known Liana since a long time, almost 2 decades now. We've been through the whole school circuit together, sans college. At school, she was acting as like my school mother. She would tie my ties before dances. She would give me advice before talking to girls. And I'm honored to say that, I'm honored to say that I'm considered Liana family, like real family, not school family. Johnnie, on the other hand, we've known each other for, since junior year in high school. And I'm sure many of you know this, Johnnie's not very likable when you first meet him. Lo siento, Mama Rodriguez. Uncle D talked about this a little bit last night, that, you know, no love is a smooth road. They've put me through hell and back as they were separate for a little bit. I felt like a stepchild. I would spend my weekends with Johnnie and my weekdays with Liana. And their love reminds me of an old adage that goes along the lines of, if love is true, you must let it go. And if it comes back, it is destined. And there's no stronger example than these two standing in front of us today. Without further ado, we are gathered here today in the presence of family and friends for the purpose of uniting Johnnie and Liana in marriage and to share the joy of this memorable occasion. There is a Filipino tradition called the candle, cord, and veil. The candle is going to represent the unity between the families of David and Rodriguez. their two flames will be joined to unite in one, and it will remain lit during the most peaceful days and through the most violent storming nights. The light of their flame is only outshone by their eternal love. It is a true symbol of unity and representation of God. And the cord is to symbolize another form of eternity. It will be a cord around their neck and a symbol of a figure eight or an infinity sign. This cord will be tying them together no matter how far apart they are. It is to represent the lifelong bond and the ties to each other and strong fidelity. The veil is a ceremonial cloth shared between the two that stand before us. From this day onward, they will be considered being clothed under one fabric, sharing the boons of each other's lives and stitching it up when it's not so successful. The veil is a symbol of health, unity, and protection.
Baby, I'm yours. And I'll be your,
what?
Yours, till the stars fall from the sky. I, yours, until the poets run out of rhyme. In other words, until I die. Baby, I'm yours. And I'll be yours until the sun no longer shines. Yours until the rivers all run dry. In other words, to the end of time. I'm gonna stay right here by your side. Doom, doom. Nothing in this world could drive me away. Every day you'll hear me say, baby, I'm yours. And I'll be yours till two and two is three. Yours till the mountains crumble to the sea. In other words, for all the eternity. Baby, I'm yours. Till the stars fall from the sky. Baby, I'm, sorry, yours. Till the rivers run dry. Baby, I'm yours. Till the poets run out of rhyme. Baby, I'm yours.
Jonathan, 10 years ago, my heart didn't know what I was getting myself into when I said yes to your ultimatum. Who honestly knew that a decade later I would be reading wedding vows to you, about to say I do as your wife? The same you that leaned in to kiss me that first time, and when I started to lean into, you turned away. You were gonna kiss me first and you turned away. We were just kids when we met at 16 years old. We grew up together, we grew apart, and then grew towards each other again. When I sat down to write these vows, I've been lying around all day, imagining what I say. How do you fit so many years of experiences and emotions into one short, not very short, kind of long speech? Do I talk about how my mom was like, who is this quiet guy with this acid wash purple V-neck?
Oh, yes.
But I was like, Mom, I like him. Maybe the summer camp where Camp Johnnie started. which made me realize that you're going to be the fun parent that sets up cardboard ships and water balloon wars, and I'm going to make our kids sit on the couch for half an hour reading and then make them summarize what they read so I know for sure that they actually did read. Lindsay. Or maybe just focus on the little things. Like when I'm sitting on the couch minding my own business and I hear, Alexa, play Dreams by Fleetwood Mac. And I look up at you swinging your hips and around singing, thunder only happens when it's raining. How you play with my hair to calm my anxiety down when I can't sleep at night? Or wink at me across the room at parties when we've been busy talking to different people? The list goes on and I can go on forever, but the one thing all of this has shown me is that we can get through anything together. Because as a wise man once said, when love is real, it finds a way. That was Avatar Roku. Season 3, episode 6. Even when we tried giving up on what we had, I don't think our hearts or our families could. Because when we took a break from each other, did we really take a break? Why were you at the Knox house when we were broken up? Why were you and my mom still messaging each other on Facebook? Even your mom was so upset about our split because she thought we were destined for each other. That just goes to show you that everyone was still rooting for us, but I don't blame them because look at us now. Look at this now, both you and I. We often get caught up in what needs to be done and what we want to accomplish next. So I want to take a moment and pause. Let's look out to our loved ones and fully take this moment in. While this is far from what we had imagined our wedding day to look like, my heart is so full. We're getting married, like literally right here, right now. How did we get so lucky to have a team like this? I'm so grateful for the life we've already started to build together with everyone by our side. To you, Jonathan, I vow to always pause and remember this feeling and remember where my heart is at right now. Because no matter what life throws at us, a coronavirus, a testing fiasco just 2 days ago, a civil unrest, or even years from now, Junie throwing an iPad in the bathtub, whatever it is, whatever it may be. What matters right now is you and me. We can get through anything together. I vow to always support you, to support you in whatever new crazy bike trip across the world you're planning. I vow to wash the dishes every now and then and try to mop the floors maybe one time. I vow to never stop eating pizza with you. I vow to keep getting out there and experiencing new things with you, from zip lining on a sketchy wooden platform in the middle of the Dominican Republic, to hiking 14 miles from our door to the Vongs, to planning annual camping trips with our family and friends. I vow to continue on reaching our life goals together and always cheering each other on in our own personal goals. I vow to always keep an open, curious mind with you, because I've never met anyone that has challenged my way of thinking like you have. You complement my life in so many ways I didn't know needed. You complete me. Although you may be the cause of some of these white hairs I have, you have truly made me a better person. A person that's learned to love myself more and fall deeper and deeper in love with you. I'm not scared of married life because I'm marrying you, my best friend. I can't wait to continue this journey with you and see where it takes us. My whole heart, my soul, my body, my family loves you. Now let's make it official and do this thing.
I can't kiss her yet?
Nope.
Is it this one?
Okay. So, starting vows. I promise that from this point on, you and I will officially be a family. We'll both belong to one another with no weird complications or asterisks or anything. It's just us. Just you and me and Pinto and Bonzo and whoever else from now until forever. I promise to make you proud. Proud of how patient you can be during all the times I know I drive you crazy. I know that I'll at least say one wrong thing during the speech and a million more wrong things down the line. I just hope that the right stuff I do say makes you proud, too. I promise that when life is chaotic and moving too quickly, I'll take the time to be present and just sit with you and just take a deep breath and let life be messy for a while. Sorry. I promise to be a good listener. And when you tell me about your sucky days, I won't offer solutions, but I'll just give you understanding. And then I'll talk shit about the people well after you're over the issue. I promise that being with you is the greatest accomplishment I could ever achieve. Through your love and support, I've been able to go after so many of my personal life goals, but I know none of what I could have done would matter if I wasn't with you. I promise to always be the goofy guy you fell in love with, to take things lightly, be easygoing so you aren't stressed during the next crazy thing that'll happen to us. I promise that after all is said and done, that one of the few things people will remember is that I completely and totally am opening my heart up to you, just you, and being vulnerable and being here. I love you so much. I promise I'll make you the happiest woman in the world if you be my wife. I'm so excited to marry you right now. The end. Oh, yeah. Do I move it over?
No.
Oh.
Liana?
Yes.
Do you take Jonathan to be your lawfully wedded spouse?
I do.
Jonathan?
Yeah.
Do you take Liana to be your lawfully wedded spouse?
Hell yeah.
By the virtue of the authority vested in me as the Deputy Commissioner of Civil Marriages for the County of Alameda, I now pronounce you married under the laws of the state of California. You may now seal the deal. You may now seal your eternal love with a kiss.
I am honored to present Mr. and Mrs. Rodriguez.
My sister just married you. Johnnie has been a part of our lives for over 10 years now, but it seems like only yesterday he was shoving Barbie underwear on the head of my Ken doll. Or Liana was taking me out to some expensive restaurant like Black Angus or sushi. It all started on the day I was born. My mom told me after she gave birth to me, Liana was crying in the corner. My only question to Liana is why the best thing ever just came into your life. Those must have been tears of joy. As for Johnnie, I can't remember how we met because I was too young, but I know he didn't cry. I also know we became friends really fast enough where we would dress up Barbies together. To Johnnie, welcome to the family. I know we're gonna make a lot more memories together, and thank you for being the older brother I always wanted. To Liana, thank you for helping me grow up. Without you, I don't know where I would be right now. You've helped me in so many ways and given me so much advice. So here's some advice from me. It's gonna get hard sometimes, but like you said in your song Weatherman, With you, I'll be all right. Love you guys. Congrats. When Liana started bringing Johnnie around, I was an antisocial middle schooler. Nothing much has changed. And he was just some awkward kid Liana brought around that I never really got to know. Nothing much has changed. But they were happy, so I was happy for them. Their relationship isn't perfect, and they butt heads sometimes, but at the end of the day, they're very much obviously each other's person. Liana and Johnnie are different in a lot of ways. People always say the cliche, opposites attract, blah, blah, blah. But they're also very similar. You know, they love nature, exploring the outdoors, biking, their cats, their families, alcohol, drinking a little too much alcohol. But most importantly, they both understand that being together means putting in the work. It means growing as individuals and growing together, which is exactly what I've seen them do for the past 10 years. There's no doubt that they love each other and will take care of each other for the rest of their lives.
We're not supposed to be on our phones at work, but, you know, I have mine out anyways. And they were, yeah. But I was at the front, and everyone was at Gene Sweeney for Liana's party. And I get this FaceTime call, and I'm like, oh, crap. I have to pick this up. So I pick it up, I walk to the back, and I see Johnnie down on one knee, and I just I'm like laughing and crying. I just remember in the back of the Manor Square shed just like screaming through the phone.
If I were to describe John and Liana's relationship, it'd be one word, adventure. Over the years, these two have been through many adventures, countless amazing moments, and even some that tested their bond. Through it all, these two have always been each other's anchor. They say the best adventures are the ones that you have someone to share it with. To the theme of adventure, John, you are the reliable compass to map the path ahead. Liana, you are the bright light to guide and point the way.
from when we were little to LARPing to going to your parties, turning off all the lights and having a battle royale. And whoever had whoever started crying or had a black eye, then it was done. I just remember when one of those, I had a black eye, and I was just crying my eyes out, and Tatan was like, "Here's a Reptar, you just won the fight." that just shows who he is as a person, always caring for other people, you know.
You have to go to jail. Put your house on up for sale. Did you get a good lawyer? Hope you didn't catch a tan. Hope you find the right man who'll fix it for you. Are you shopping anywhere? Change the color of your hair. Are you busy? Did you have to pay your fine? That you were dodging all the time. Are you still dizzy? Since I've come on home, well, my body's been a mess. And I miss your ginger hair and the way you like your dress. Won't you come on over?
Stop making a fool out of me. Why don't you come on over, Valerie?
Valerie. I go out by myself and I look across the water. And I think of all the things what you're doing, and in my head I paint a picture. Since I've come on home, well, my body's been a mess, and I miss your ginger hair and the way you like to dress. Won't you come on over? I'm making a fool out of me. Why don't you come on over, Valerie? Valerie. Valerie. Valerie.
Okay, can we just fade out now?
Valerie.